Hello guys, today we are going to discuss about the topic lambda expressions. First of all, what is meant by lambda expressions and why they have introduced lambda expressions in our Java 8 we are going to see in detail with example. This is the content which I am going to submit to you in this particular video. Whereas, first of all, what is meant by lambda expressions? What is functional interface? What is the relationship between lambda expressions and functional interface? And the use of lambda expressions and why they have introduced in our Java? With an example, we are going to see. Basically, lambda expression is a new feature which has been introduced into Java 8. It is used to iterate, filter, and extract the data from a collection. Basically, in my previous video, if you check it out, I have shown the example of for each. In for each also, I had used lambda expression. Whereas, by making use of for each, I used to retrieve individual elements from a list or map. You can check out that particular video for more information. Whereas, this lambda expression, it has decreased the usage of anonymous inner class. Previously, if you check it out, whenever if you need to create a thread by making use of anonymous inner class, how we used to create runtime r equal to new runtime and anonymous functionality we used to provide. That is a way where that particular functionality, all those particular details has been reduced by making use of lambda expressions. Now, what is functional interface is all about? An interface with only one method is called as functional interface. Where in Java, we have runtime. We just take an example of runtime. This particular runtime is an interface for creating a thread, where that particular runtime interface provides only run method. That particular run method, you can make it as functional interface. In Java 8, we have got a new annotation called as functional interface. What is the use of this particular annotation? Whenever if you are defining any interface with a single method, then you can provide this particular annotation on the top of that particular interface so that our compiler JDK will get to know that it is a functional interface. And this particular annotation is optional. It is not a mandatory, it is optional. If you want, you can specify. Now, what is the use of lambda expression? Basically, if you need to override any particular interface and provide the body for that particular interface in a class, otherwise, if you need to provide the body for a particular interface by making use of anonymous class, it is tough. Lines of code is more. To make it more simple, and to reduce the lines of code in Java 8, they have introduced lambda expression. This is the syntax of lambda expression. You can see, this is the argument list, and this is the arrow token, and this is the body. Argument list, this it can be empty, otherwise it can contain an object, whereas this arrow token, you might have seen this kind of signature in your C++. Basically, this is used to link argument list and the body. Body is the place where you can write your particular expressions as well as statements for evaluating lambda expressions. Now, how this particular signature or syntax will be used, we are going to see with a simple example. Yes, you can see over here, I have an interface. This is a sample interface which has single method, say hi. And as I said, this functional interface, this is available in Java 8 and this is optional. If you want, you can specify this, otherwise you can ignore. And this is the old way of providing the body for this particular interface abstract methods. Just we were implementing this particular interface, we were overriding the method and we were providing the body statements. Whatever the logic you want to evaluate, you were able to provide it over here. Later, if you need to call this particular object or method, we need to create an object for that particular class, and we used to call that particular method by making use of that object. You can see this. I will comment this code, and this is the first way. Still, some of the people they are using in their projects. You can see, say hi 6. It has printed. So this is oldest way, where this particular concept in Java 8 is not recommended. Whereas, let me comment this. Next, another way is anonymous inner class. This particular interface has single method. Now, here you can see the second way is anonymous inner class. Let me uncomment this. Just simple. Sample interface, sample equal to new sample interface. And I have overridden the body over here. This object I had used over here to invoke the function. So in this way also, you can execute or you can override the methods of that respective interface. This is also one of the important way which we were using in our previous programming. Whereas, now this concept and this concept is completely removed from Java 8. We are using lambda expressions, which looks in this fashion. You can see, sample interface, I'm creating a reference for that particular respective interface. And this is an object where this particular object, you have seen already, this is an argument list and we will be passing. You can see system.out.println. This is our body exactly where we will be holding our logics. Say hi and I value. What is I value? That will be the argument what we are passing to say hi. Now, first you can see sample say hi 6. We are assigning to this I, whereas that particular I is this one, where the arguments will be assigned to this I variable. That I variable we are printing out over here. Where some people will be thinking that this I and this I both are same. Absolutely no. You can see here, this is simple identity. You can consider it as a reference or argument which I am making use. You can specify instead of I, you can specify anything over here. So whatever I am passing 6 to this, that will be available into this argument list. That argument list I am printing out over here. Now this is very simple. I don't want to write extra lines of code. In a single line only I have executed the code. You can see the output. So this is the the way of using your lambda expressions. And I'm enabling this functional interface also. If you want, you can enable it. This is simply optional, just for providing the information. That's it about lambda expressions. Thank you.